messy people. I want to say a little bit about this piece, this first piece. This was a commission that Scott and I put in process a little while ago, quite honestly, before the pandemic started. We had agreed with Stacy to have this piece written for saxophone and marimba, which is a genre that Scott and I have really been exploring for the last 15, 16 years. And little did we know that almost as soon as we signed the contract and made everything set and set all of our dates, that we'd be in the middle of a global pandemic. And that affected what Stacy wrote. Stacy, I believe, is watching from California. Welcome, Stacy, and all the others online. This first movement is called Groundhog Day and reflects the rather repetitious get up, stay at home, do your thing kind of grind that we all sort of hunkered down into during the pandemic. And then making lemonade, we talk about, you know, when life deals you lemons, make lemonade. And we found many things like how to meet online, how to put 3,000 miles on your car instead of 15, how to burn a lot less fossil fuel, how to spend more time at home with family. A lot of silver linings came out of that. And so we made lemonade out of this lemon that we're still dealing with a little bit, or a lot. This is Silver Linings, world premiere of Stacy Garrett. Thank you. So there are a couple of intermingling themes that are going on in this recital, one of which is, for reasons I can now no longer remember, I thought it might be fun to play soprano, alto, tenor, and barisaxophone on the same recital. So this is a soprano, well, this piece could be for any of the instruments, E-flat or B-flat. The composer, Mark Kilstoft, is a dear friend, wrote a sonata for me about 23 years ago now already. He's on the faculty at Furman. He's a wonderful composer and a dear friend. This piece was originally written for oboe. You still? Yes, I know. That must be Hassan Anderson, our new oboe teacher. It's a beautiful piece written for Petria Varnik, who has lived in this town, but I think is now living in Greenville. The Ricercar Doloroso and the Turkey Trot, as it were, this is dedicated to her teacher, oboist John Mack. And there are two themes in the Ricercar that exemplify the year he started and the year he finished as principal oboe in the Cleveland Symphony, 1965, which you hear right out of the gate, and then 2001, which is the year he retired, which will come in a little bit later. The Turkey Trot has to do with a turkey, dancing turkey story that John Mack was famous for telling. I got the story from Petria this afternoon. I see this movement in a whole different light all of a sudden. But this was two things that signify and exemplify John Mack's career.
Thank you.
Continuing with our poultry theme, if I can get it to open up, we have a tune by an Australian saxophonist and composer, Barry Cockcroft. And Barry was fooling around with the Barrio Sequenza that we play on soprano, and as he is wont to do, started just sort of doodling around and improvising, making some funny sounds. One of his roommates told him he sounded like a chicken. Cuckoo is Swahili for chicken, can also mean crazy, it can mean cuckoo clock, has multiple meanings, but this is Barry Cockcroft's take on cuckoo.
Thank you.
Starting to have a little more compassion for my percussion colleague who has logistics in everything he plays. Don't tell him I said that, he's backstage. This next piece is another premiere. This was a consortium of 30 saxophonists led by a doctoral student here, Andrew Hutchins. Andrew's been really active commissioning a lot of really good pieces and good composers. Belgian de Secon actually did an undergraduate degree here in percussion. And then did some graduate degrees in composition. He's now on the faculty at Penn State. And At the Seams is scored for tenor saxophone and piano, completed 3 or 4 months ago, I think, if I'm not mistaken. And the seams that he's talking about are pitch and time domains. And as they sort of homogenize, interact, fall apart, it works in 4 segments. Opening section, where the threading together of the material is most lucid. A developmental section that explores juxtaposition of pitches and rhythms from different structural realms assigned discreetly to the piano and saxophone. A third segment that experiences the expansion and contraction of rhythmic and pitch materials as the piano and saxophone parts become unglued. And a final segment that searches for the structural strength experienced in the opening, but never finds it. This is At the Seams by Balthazar Seven.
Thank you. Thank you. mainstream lexicon.
A little bit of telling the story too. Let's see if I actually brought it out with me. Nope, I didn't. Well, it's two different kind of back and forth issues that build to a head and just break free real near the end. This is Liberation by Joel Love.
Thank you.
Thank you.
first piece that we're going to play, Scott and I premiered last March. I think it was last March. Time sort of got funky last year, as you know. This is a former student of ours here who's teaching at Benedict College.
Louisiana Monroe.
He's at Louisiana Monroe now. Oh, he's moved. Joe Moore was a percussion student here and has done a lot of composing. And this is his piece that he wrote for the Rosalind duo, Scott and me, called Astronomically Speaking. You know what? I'm going to come a little closer. I did that already this afternoon. Thank you.
Next piece is also borrowed with the permission of the composer, Gene Kaczynski. This was originally written for bassoon, and if you know anything about the bassoon, you'll know they love to crow their reeds, which you will hear at some point as close as I can get, and you might recognize a lick near the end of the piece.